Hello friends, Dr. Sangeeta with you for another lecture of Dental Pathshala. Thanks for the comments. They are helpful and keeps me going and motivated to put more videos. And today's topic is behavior shaping. So let's get started. Behavior shaping is a step-by-step procedure to make the child involved in the dental therapy. Behavior shaping means shaping the behavior by the dentist to teach a child how to behave in a dental clinic. Children need to be cooperative during the dental procedure. They need to be a little bit communicative, because children cannot grasp the overall procedure in a single explanation. Therefore, we need to explain child the procedure, how and what we are doing on the child. So a child needs explanation and he has a little bit low level of understanding, but we can make them understand using euphemism. Euphemisms are the indirect word or expressions. These actually are the substitutes word which can be used in presence of a children. The choice of word can be a level which a child can understand. Therefore, it is very important that we address the child some euphemism or reframing. Now, the anesthetic solution can be referred as the water to put the teeth to sleep, and caries, we can say it as a tooth bug. Rubber dam can be used as a raincoat, and radiograph can be said as a tooth picture or the picture of a tooth. Behavior shaping involves the use of reinforce, as we have studied in the operant conditioning theory by the Skinner. If you want to read about the reinforce and punishment, you can click the link in the description below and up in the I button. So behavior shaping is using the reinforces and changing the child behavior from inappropriate behavior to an appropriate behavior. So let me give you an example. When a child enters the dental clinic, when a child enters in the reception room, and he associates the previous dental experience which was unpleasant. Now the child starts crying. This is an external response, but the internal response of the child would be fear and anxiety. So we are shaping the child behavior to make the child involved in the dental treatment. Behavior modifications involve three techniques: desensitization, modeling, and contingency management. So let's start with desensitization. Desensitization is removing the fears, removing the bad dental experience which a child previously had, or removing a negative behavior or unpleasant dental experience. The most popular method we used for modifying the behavior of a child by desensitization is telling the children and showing the children and doing the treatment. So this is tell, show, do technique. Ed Leslon in 1959 introduced the concept of tell, show and do, so TSD technique. The dentist uses the language that a child can understand and tells the child what is to be done. And it is presented by slowing and repeatedly showing and slowly. Dentist can also use euphemisms to tell the children. Now, after telling, dentist shows the procedure to child using a model, or he can tell this himself, but it is done slowly. Now the dentist proceeds to do the dental procedure which exactly he described it. Tell, show, do technique is telling and showing every step and instrument and explains what is going to be done. By telling, showing and doing, a child can overcome the small dental fear or small dental anxiety related to the dental treatment. And this technique is done in the children more than 3 years of age. And also in a fearful child or during a first visit or any subsequent visit when you are introducing any new dental procedure to the child. We can also use tell, show, do technique in apprehensive child because of the information received from parents. And this technique is popularly used nowadays for modifying the behavior by desensitizing the child. Coming to the second behavior modification technique, which is modeling. Modeling induced by Bandura, and it is developed from the social learning principle. And the modeling procedure involves allowing a patient to observe on one or more individuals, or you can also demonstrate the procedure using models. Models can be live models, sibling or the parents of the child or any other patient, or you can also show the filmed models or the posters or any visual audio aid. You can also run a film cassette showing all the procedure which is to be done on the child. Modeling actually improved the behavior of an apprehensive child who had not had any previous dental experience. And the good thing about live modeling is you don't require any additional armamentarium or equipment. So modeling can be done using live models, any patient, filmed models, posters or audiovisual aids. Coming to the third technique of behavior modification, which is our contingency management. Now you must have been familiarized with contingency word. If you remember the operant conditioning theory, which we have already covered, if you haven't watched the video, I'll give you a link in the description below and up in the I button. Now, contingency is the relationship between the operant and the consequences. And if you remember, operant is the behavior that operates or controls the environment. So we will be talking about the reinforcement, which we have already studied in the operant conditioning theory. And we'll be talking about the reinforcement, the positive reinforcement, the negative reinforcement, and also the punishments. Contingency management is a method of modifying the behavior of a child by presenting, by giving rewards or withdrawing any reinforcement. Now we'll be talking about two terms, the positive reinforcement and the negative reinforcement. If you remember the Skinner operant conditioning theory, positive reinforcement occurs if the pleasant consequences follows the response if a child is rewarded for a good behavior during the dental experience. So a positive reinforcement is the one whose contingent presentation increases the frequency of the behavior. While on the other hand, negative reinforcement involves the removal of the unpleasant stimulus following a response. Now taking the toy back or sending the child parents outside. So a negative reinforcement is the one whose contingent withdrawal increases the frequency of the behavior. So a positive reinforcement is the one which increases the frequency of the behavior by presenting something, by applying a pleasant consequences which follows the response. And a negative reinforcement is usually termination of an aversive stimulus. We can say withdrawing the mother from the clinic. We can also praise the child or pat the child on the shoulder or the back to give a positive reinforcement, or we can also give rewards in form of toys, in form of games. But sweets are usually not rewarded since it causes caries, and being a dentist, we should not recommend it. We can also use TV shows or games as positive reinforcement. So this is about behavior shaping, and we have studied three techniques for behavior modification of a child: desensitization, modeling, and contingency management. And we have also studied the tell, show, do technique, which is a popular technique for desensitizing a child. So that's about behavior shaping. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment below. Give it a thumbs up if you like the video. And subscribe to the channel. Subscribe to Dental Pathshala if you like our channel. And if you want to get more